Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. My name is Numan Tariq, and today we would study about selecting series data. Then we would go through the selection of data from rows and columns simultaneously, and in the end we would study about selecting data lexicographically. So basically, whenever we would work in a Jupyter notebook, the first thing that is required is to import the libraries. So here the libraries are NumPy and pandas. So we have to import pandas as pd and import NumPy as np. Then we need a data to work on. So basically, first of all, we would go through a very simple concept of selection of data, and then we would perform it over an Excel sheet or CSV file. So I have written there a command that a is equals to np dot arrange parentheses 1, 15, 2. So basically this relation 1, 15, 2 is showing that I need data from 1 to 15 with a gap of 2. So when I would write over here a, so this is showing me a data containing 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11 and 13. So if I would reduce the space like from 2 to 1, it would provide me a data from 1 to 14. Here 14 is present but 15 is not. This is because of the reason of n minus 1. That's why the 15th value, like 15, is not available over there. Now let's suppose we want to have a data from this array. So what to do? Here is the query. If I want data from 7 to 14, so I would need to write this command, like a square bracket 6 colon 14. And when we run this, it shows 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. Here, 6, it is starting from the 6th value and ends at 14. But basically, when we see the data, it's from 1 to 14. Here, the 6th value would be 7, because whenever we perform the operations, we come to know that the rows and columns starts from 0. The indexing starts from 0. It starts like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. So at index 0, it would be 1. At 1, it would be 2. At 2, it would be 3, and so on. So at 6, it would be 7. But as there is 14, so n minus 1, 14 minus 1, 13. So at number 13th, it would be 14. That's why it had selected the data from 7 to 14. 7 is the 6th value and 14 is the 13th value over here. That's why we got the series of data that is from 6 to 14, but the result is 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13. 13th value, because 14 minus 1 is equals to 13, so it provides us 13th value. Now if we want data from a 1 to 12 but with a gap of 2, so we need to perform this operation. So a square bracket 1 colon 12 colon 2. This shows that I need data from 1 to 12 with a gap of 2. So at 1 we have 2, and at 12 minus 1, 11, we have 12, but with a gap of 2. So 2 plus 2, 4, plus 2, 6, plus 2, 8, plus 2, 10, and plus 2, 12. So in this way, it provides us data from 1, first 2, 12, but for n minus 1, it's 11th, and with a gap of 2. Now let's suppose we want to have data like the 6th value, the 10th value and the 12th value. So for this we would write this particular code, which shows that a square bracket for 2 times and then 6, 10, 12. So it would provide us the values like 7, 11 and 13. The 7 is the 6th value, the 11 is the 10th value and the 13th is the 12th value. I hope you got the point. And now we will use an other data, that is b is equals to np dot array small bracket np dot matrix. I will explain this particular thing in a bit later. Like, first of all, I would like to tell you that we are importing here a matrix data, so that you would be able to understand that how you can select a data from a matrix. So first, so as to select a matrix or to import a matrix, you would just write b is equals to np dot array small bracket np dot matrix, and then like whatever the data you want to have in the matrix. Here I have written that 1, 2, 3, 4 and semicolons. Semicolon is to break the row. This one would be the first row and this one would be the second row. But because of indexing, this would be called 0 and this would be 1 whenever we would write to select data from matrix. So this is the result that shows a matrix of 2 rows and 4 columns. Now let's suppose I want to have a data like 7 out of this matrix. So I would write over here, first of all, b, then square bracket, number of row, as the first row is 0 and the second is 1 in the indexing. So I would use over here 1 because it's second row, and 7 is located in the third column, but n minus 1, so it would be second, 2. So again, square bracket and 2. First we would write the row and second we would write the column. So then we have the result. Similarly, if I would write b square bracket 0, that is first row, and first column likes the value over here would be the desired one that we need to select. This was a very simple concept of how to select the data from a series. Now we will go on to the CSV file. This the method of importing a CSV file in Jupyter is very much easy, and it is also explained by Sir Dr. Faisal Mirza in his video over YouTube, and I would also explain in a very few seconds over here. Like, you just have to write this command where you are writing data1. Data1 is the folder that we have opened in the Jupyter notebook, and then we have renamed it as the data1 and imported or uploaded a file of university in it. So this is very much easier rather than providing a complete path like C slash something something. it is basically very much easy to select a data in this particular form. It is called institution name, and country is equals to university, square bracket country, like the country of the university is from university data, and column country. So country dot head, it will provide us the name of the country and the country, name of the universities and the name of the countries. The data of university is basically the data of the top 10 universities in the world. So it would be very easy for all of you to understand. So first of all, I would perform an ILSC command. ILSC and LSC are the indexers, and these were used for the selection of data from series. So if I am writing over here like country dot ILSC, so it would provide me the third row would be the result. If I want data from the fifth one, then I would write over here 5. As we know that the indexing starts from 0, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's remove the head so as to have complete data. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 is also in between these three dots. So let's change the number. Let's change it with 2. So here 0, 1, 2, and at 2 it is California. That is the result. So you can also confirm your result using this method. Then ILSC, country dot ILSC, 2 times square bracket, 1, 5, comma, 7. This is for so as to select multiple rows. Like if you want data of multiple universities like Oxford University, University of Cambridge, Stanford University, you just need to write their indexes so that it would fetch data for you. So country.ilsc 1, 5, 7. This is basically showing that we need data of 1st, 5th and 7th university. So we have the result of University of Cambridge, Imperial College London, and University College London. Then here we have country.ilsc, square bracket 4, 50, 10. This is basically a command to have data from 4 to 50, but with a gap of 10. Sorry, we have only the data from 1 to 10. And let's suppose the gap is 3. We have 3 universities, first 0, then 1, so 1. At 1 we have University of Cambridge, then the 9th one, and then the with the gap of 3. So we have these 3 universities. So country dot, then we have another command, that country dot LOC. LOC is used for labels, and ILSC is used for numbers. Like here I have written the numbers, so then I would use ILSC. But if I would write the name or labels of the industries, so then I would write to I would have to write LOC command. So when I have written the name of the industry in the LOC, I would have the result like the name of the country where the industry is located. Again, this is the explanation, or this is the a more better way, or another technique to have the data. Like here in the above section, we are just using the indexing, like the number of the university, but now we are using the name of the university. But the method is almost the similar. The thing that differ is that we are using a you can say name of the universities rather than the number of universities, and also we are replacing ILOC by LOC. So then here we have we are starting from University of Oxford till Princeton University, and with the gap of 2. So this one is the first university, and this one is the 10th university, and we want data from 1 to 10 with a gap of 2. So it will provide us first, then third, then fifth, then seventh, then ninth. Okay, I hope you all are getting the point. And then we have country dot. Then sorry, this one is country. It is performing the data very well, but we need to remove the errors. So country.iloc. No, we can use the data in the opposite direction as well. This one was a form from up to down, and this one is from down to top. So here I am using the 10th university. I want data from the 10th university to the first university with a gap of minus 4, like it is starting from bottom to top. So I would have data that is this one. It provide me the 10th university, then minus 5, that is 10 minus, minus 4. So 10 minus 4, it is 6th university, and then we have the 2nd university, that is University of Cambridge, as shown over here. Now we have written the command of dd.option.display.maximum-rows. So what we want in the display, that the maximum rows would be 9. We can set them, like we can say that it should be 6. So you would find the change over, or you would see the change over here. Like if I have written over there 6 and change the value, and now I am getting, look at this. This has been changed, and we have a rows number 6. We have total 6 rows shown or on display. Now we are using again the command of iloc, like university.iloc 6. So we would have the rows of country, like columns. This is the name of columns, like country is California, undergraduate diversity is 1592, and so on. Then if we want the same thing using the name of the university, so we would need to just replace the 6 with the name of university, that is University College London, or it could be University of Cambridge, Stanford University, or anything else, but it should be present in the name of the universities. And we have to change the ILOC with LOC, and it would provide us the results. Just to make it more clear, we can also perform another thing. It is like we are using over there the numbers to select the data. Like I want the 3rd university, the 5th university, and the 9th university. This 3rd is n-1, 2, 2nd, this is 4th, and this is 8th, using the n-1 form. So I would have the data of the 2nd university, the 4th university, and the 8th university. So here we have this much data. Like if you want the data of fifth university, you would have to write over here like just 6 and just use single brackets. But if you want to have multiple rows of data, so you have to use 2 square brackets, ILC command for numbers, and just write the number of rows that you want with using a comma. Now we are going to use the command that is labels. Labels is basically a form in which the selection of data is much more easier. First of all, you would just define labels. Like labels could be the name of the universities or name of the countries, but here we are using the name of universities. So I want data of 3 universities, namely as defined over here. And labels is equals to square bracket then inverted commas, first university, second university, and third university. I want the data of these 3 universities. So as label is defined as this, so we can use labels in our next command other than this, because these 2 are equal. So university.loc square bracket labels, so this would provide us the same result. I would just explain in a very small step over here. Like agar, if I am using just a second. If I remove the label and just simply place this thing over here, so this is showing an error. Too many indexes. This is the labels command is basically for so as to minimize the number of indexes. So this would not be done in this way. So let's keep it and move on. So again, then we have another query that is university.ilc. Like I want the data from 1 to 9. That is from the University of Cambridge to University of Chicago. So we can change the numbers over here. Like I want the data from 1 to 6. So this would provide us the data of University of Cambridge. That is the first. Then that is the way second university in the data. First one is University of Oxford, but 0 is for University of Oxford and 1 is for University of Cambridge. That's why it has selected the University of Cambridge. Then we have the data up till 5th university, that is 5th university, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is Imperial College, London. Then we have another method of selecting the data, that is using a start and stop command. In this way, we can use this command for labels. Like I want the data to be started from University of Cambridge, that is the second university, and I want to stop the data like at University of Chicago. So I want data basically from University of Cambridge to up till University of Chicago. So here we have to define start as the name of the university from where we can start, and define stop as the name of the university where we want to end or up till the point we want the data. So again, we are going to use loc command, that is industry.loc, because these are labels, these are not numbers. So we would use loc command and then start colon stop. This would select the data between and data from start to stop, that is University of Cambridge to University of Chicago. Let's see the result. Here are the results. It selected data from University of Cambridge to April in the University of Chicago. Sorry. This coding is very interesting if we would give a very small time to it and try to understand the concept, the basic concepts. It would be very easy for us to do it, and I hope so that you all are getting the points and understanding. And I would apologize if you could not, and maybe someone else could easily understand, but you could not. So again, we are now going to select data frame, rows and columns simultaneously. Here we would select the rows and columns simultaneously. Like in the above section, we were just focusing on the rows, but now we are going to focus on rows and columns. We want the whole data, like the rows as well as columns. So over here, this is the query, that industry.iloc, because these are numbers, and colon 3 comma colon 4. This is basically showing that we want data that contain first 3 rows and first 4 columns. So we have the result, that is first 3 universities, first 3 rows, and first 4 columns. First row, second row, third, and 0, 1, 2, and 3. That's why column 3. And 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So that's why column 4. First 3 rows and first 4 columns. Now if we change the numbers with the labels or names of the universities and the name of column, so we can use loc command, that is university.loc, Stanford University, and then we are that we want the data up till Stanford University and up to undergraduate black columns. So we have the results as given below. Now if we want all rows but just 2 columns, so we can use this command. I have used over there head, but if we would remove it, it would provide us all the rows, that is 10 rows. These 3 dots are basically showing and they are representing that the other rows also exist. So there were 10 rows and 2 columns. For so as to do this, we just need to use iloc command, that is university.iloc scare bracket colon comma scare bracket 4 comma 6. Here we are providing the information that we want all rows through using a single column, colon, and then we are using comma, and after that we are using again a scare bracket which contains 4 and 6, like we want just 4th and 6th column. So we have all the rows over here and just 4th and 6th column. This query can also be run using the names rather than numbers. So just we have to again replace the numbers with the names of the columns, and the column will be would remain the same, and we would use the loc command, and you would see that the result were similar in both the cases. If you see the results were all same. No, university dot another query that is university dot ILOC 2 comma 5 and comma then 4 comma 9. So we just want, if we want two rows and two columns or three rows and three columns, so we just need, let's suppose we consider to have three rows. I want the second one, the fourth one and the fifth one, as I have already written it, and we can increase over there like 7. So we want three rows and three columns. So we have three rows and three columns, second, fourth, ninth, fifth, and fourth column, seventh column, and ninth column. Then we are going to use the concept again. This is the same concept as we have started and stated the in the start and stop session. Like we just define over there start and then stop, but here we would use rows and columns. We are defining basically rows. That rows should be California Institute of Technology and Massachusetts Institute of Technology, and then the columns would be these two. We are just defining the rows and then columns. So in this way, we would again in the LOC command, we would use just these two labels so as to perform the operation. So university.loc square bracket rows, this row is basically the representative of this whole thing, that is this one, okay? And column is basically representing this thing. So we have the results like two universities as the names are already mentioned, and two columns whose names are also mentioned in the query of columns. Then we have university.iloc command and 5 comma minus 4. If we want the data like in a particular cell, that I want data from fifth row but minus fourth column, like it should not be sixth or eighth column, it should be minus fourth. So it would rather from starting starting from left to right, it would start from right to left, and it would start like minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. So it would select the data from fifth row and minus fourth column, so that particular cell value would be represent over here. Then we are going to use the command of like the similar thing, but in another manner. Like we are using the same, we are going to perform the similar operation but using LOC command. So basically, we would use university.loc square bracket the name of the university, that is the from the row side, and the name of the column. So it would provide us the data in that particular cell where the row is starting like California Institute of Technology and the column is undergraduate student undergraduate diversity of students at NHPI. Then we have university.iloc 10 colon 1 colon minus 2 comma 5. Here if we see, so we have like we want data from, rather than from top to bottom, we want data from bottom to top. So we would use the maximum over here and the minimum over here, like 10 colon 1 colon minus 2. This minus 2 is basically as we are going from bottom to top, so we would use minus 2. If it was a simple query, like we were selecting data from top to bottom, then there was no need of minus sign and we would just write 2. But in this case, we are removing from bottom to top and selecting data from bottom to top. So this for this reason, we are using here a negative sign or a minus sign, and with a gap of 5. Sorry. This one is not like that. University.iloc 10 colon 1 colon minus 2 comma 5. Okay. This one is basically representing the row and this one is representing the column. So basically it shows that we want rows from 10 to 1 with a gap of minus 2. This one is defined like rows that we want Princeton University, Princeton University, then University of London, that is after minus 2, and so on. And we want fifth column. So fifth column would contain this data. 0.0227, 0.0053, and so on. Again, we are going to use the start and stop command over here again. And here we have defined start as we have defined above in our above section. And then we are defining stop. And again, we would use this start colon stop with a gap of minus 1. This is basically to select rows. And we want data from that particular column. So in this way, we would have that much data. Again, we are starting from bottom, that is the 10th university, and stop at the top university, that is University of Oxford, with a gap of 1, that is start colon stop, like start from this university from in the bottom and end at or stop at University of Oxford with a gap of minus 1. This is to define the row, and again this is for column, that is after a comma. So here we have this much results. Again, changing it to the heading so that you would easily know that which section had been added and which we are going to start. Now we are going to start the section that is like slicing lazy graphically. Sorry. Now again, I have used the same command as in the starting. I have used like industry is equal to pd.read. Again, we are reading this particular file industry from data 1, and it is called institution name university dot sort index. So here we are just going to sort the index to make it more easier for us to perform other operations or slicing lazy graphically. So if I would remove the add, we would have all the universities, that is starting from University of Oxford till Princeton University. And let's suppose you there a head. Head is basically to select first 5 rows. Then again we have used the display option command, that is pd.options.display and maximum rows 6. That the maximum number of rows should be 6. It could be 9, it could be 10, it could be 7, anything. And university.loc, loc is because we are using here like letters, not numbers or labels. So here this query is when you want to don't know the names of the universities. Like if I want to know the name of the universities from A to Z, or like from M to Z, so just I would write over here, this is the start and this is the end. Like universities having starting name UN and universities having starting name IM. So when we would perform this query, we would have the results like the three universities whose names are starting with UN, that is university. There is an error. Why? UN. as you have seen over here that I have written the query like start from UN and add at UK, like the first letter of the name of the university should be UN or end at UK. So I have University College of London, University College or University of Cambridge and University of Oxford. Let's suppose if I would use like A and Z. So this is showing no results because there is no university whose name is starting from A, and also there is no university whose name is starting from Z. So I would use UN as the names contain UN like university, and I would use over here IM like Imperial College London. So this is again not showing any sort of thing because there are no Let's have the same one. Okay, the university is equals to university dot sort index ascending false, and university dot index is monatomic decreasing. So again, so if we would false the index ascending order, that is the indexing should be then descending one. So again, university dot index is monatomic decreasing. So this command would be considered true and the result would also be true. Then we have university.lsc start from E and ends at B. This is basically in the opposite direction, like it is not from A to E or B to E, it is from E to B, that is the opposite one. So it would provide us just C because C is the only one amongst the name of the universities who is located between or whose starting letter is between E and B. So let's suppose if I would use over here U, so we would have more universities, like we have the starting letter T, S, P and all of these in the in between B and U or U and B. So this was all about today's lecture. I hope so that you would understand it very well. In case of any sort of queries, you can comment in the comment section. And if you have any sort of query, you can ask. So Fasil Mir, hope so that you would understand it. Thank you so much. And in case of any sort of mistake, I would apologize.